Welcome. There is the last day of Aaron. Okay. All of you have been there since the war. We started HTML for beginners. We wrap it up. I went to CSS for beginners. And then move on to advanced HTML, advanced CSS. And now here, I will tell you congratulations. Be able to do all that I've been doing from the war. Everything about CSS and HTML will no longer be a problem for you. That is my goal. That is what I want to achieve. Okay? So today, I want to do this with you. I want to show us all the things we're going to do today. Okay? Let me just take you to our website that we've been designing. Today, this is the last of the website. And we want to create a footer page. Look at the color I give the footer page, background color and all that. So if you check where you see it's moving, right? Sweet, sweet, sweet. Everything is working well. And it's actually clickable. You can actually click it. And if you put any of these websites, any of the page here, it's going to take you to the page. And of course, I know you know how to create all of these pages differently and then link it up to each of these. I also want to click on it to get them to the page. But though, like I always tell you, HTML CSS lack functionality. But at the same time, you can actually make them function a little. Okay, for example, these are Facebook icon, Twitter icon, Instagram icon, and LinkedIn icon. You can actually copy our Facebook. I will show you where you can place it. And when somebody come over here and click on it, it will take you direct to your Facebook. Just if you could remember, when we are talking about links and anchor tag at the initial stage of HTML, we showed you how you can link to Google, right? How you can link to your homepage, your about page, and stuff like that. It's just the same method. But now you link them up with any of these. When somebody click on it, display it immediately. So I want you on your own to create your about us page, get your service page, depending on what you want to produce. Create your privacy policy page, get your terms and condition page, get your affiliate program page, get your FAQ page, create your contact page, create your track your order page for those who are into e-commerce, okay? You can actually create an e-commerce website just like this. There's nothing, no difference, okay? Then create a payment page, a software engineer, digital marketer, and stuff like that. Just create it. Of course, they will lack functionality because we are not yet in JavaScript. But the good news is that that is where we are going. That is where we are going. And that is why I want all of us here to follow this class one after the other. So by the time we get to JavaScript, be very, very easy for you to be that difficult. You have to be difficult anyway, but if you pass on through this stage, you will find it so difficult. Okay, so go ahead and create all this page and watch me as I show you how you can actually bring all these things here and then you link it together with yours and then see how it can work. Okay, if you could say, check here, I actually create this to copyright page and stuff like that. After you create this, or do much, much better. The same process, the same method. And here's the contact material. I'm going to start at the initial stages. Contact form. So you can actually click here, put his email address, put his password, and click on login. And if you go to login and put your Gmail account, for instance, before you click on login, you must come to your Gmail account. Okay? So gradually, we are coming to the end of our CSS and HTML tutorial, the final project. Don't worry. If you are finding it difficult to create any of those things I mentioned, you don't need to worry. All you need to do is to check on the playlist. I have a playlist on HTML for beginner, a CSS for beginner. Go over it once again. Practice all that was there, all that is there, and then see how you can fit it. See how you can learn those that you've forgotten, and then come back here and continue the journey. One more time is, you getting the principle and building yourself from there. But do not worry again, I said, because at the end of this training, after this project, I will also bring another project. On that project, they're going to create a site like YouTube. Okay? It's not going to be YouTube. It's not for anything bad. It's not for anything that's illegal. Because after all, just CSS and HTML. I'm going to show you that you can actually use HTML CSS to create some things that look like some pictures on YouTube and stuff like that, okay? So for those interested, I will also send that training to you where you can learn it. Anything must allow you to create it. It's going to be 6 hours or 7 hours lecture altogether, and at the end of it, you'll be able to practice and build something like YouTube, as I said earlier on, okay? All this will make you to become a guru in HTML and CSS. So you don't need to panic. Gradually, you will get there. But remember, the key is practice, okay? Practice, and practice. And if you lack anything, or if you are confused, kindly ask me a question, or go back to my playlist and see the one that you are confused, and say you can relearn it again. Most especially, the basics. Everything starts from basics, okay? Having said this, let's move on. Now that we are through the final project, I would like you to practice all of this, and then create that classic website of yours using just HTML and CSS, and submit it on the submission. Without much ado, let's go in. Let me show you how we can achieve all of this. Let's move in to our class.